All right, so in this video, I'm going to teach you some question answer, some important question answer about lymphocytes, that is T cells and B cells. All right, so let's get started. So first, what is a lymphocyte? First, we need to know the lymphocyte. What do you mean by a lymphocyte? Pause the video, try to figure out. All right, so we know the white blood cells, that is leukocytes. So white blood cells are colorless, we know that, and do not contain hemoglobin. So there are two main kinds of white blood cell, two main kinds of white blood cells. Number one, that is lymphocyte. Another one, that is phagocyte. I'm not writing, I'm just giving like this. That is lymphocyte and phagocytes. So lymphocytes are produced by lymph glands or lymph node. So here's a definition also. So lymphocytes are second type of white blood cells. We know that white blood cells are two main kinds. So one is lymphocytes, another one, second one, that is first one is a phagocyte, second one is a lymphocytes. All right, they play an important role in immune response. That means the lymphocyte has a large and rounded nucleus and a relatively small amount of non-granular cytoplasm, and lymphocytes tend to be nearly round in shape and only show limited movements. So that is the lymphocyte. I'm not explaining more details. So B lymphocytes. Here is a B cells. So what is B lymphocytes? So B cells, that is also known as B lymphocytes. You can say B lymphocyte or you can say B cells. So this is a B cells, a type of white blood cells of the lymphocyte subtype. This is another subtype. All right. So you just quickly remember, you can make a flashcard that can help you to remember for it can help you to for your final exam. What are T lymphocytes? So T lymphocyte, that is the T cells. All right, so you can say also T cell, this is a T cells, T lymphocyte. So T lymphocytes are part of the immune system and develop from stem cells in the bone marrow. Let's go next one. So here you can see this is a bone marrow, guys, and here is a thymus gland. So in this video, I'm just teaching that is the main question, that is the main target. Suggest why thymus gland, this is a thymus gland, becomes smaller than puberty. That means whenever teenager growing up day by day. So thymus is a gland that lies in the chest. So you see that this is a chest area and beneath the sternum. Where is it? Beneath the sternum. It's double in size when birth and puberty, between birth and puberty. This is the period of time. And after puberty, what happened? It shrinks. Thymus is a vital yet unusual organ. So vital in that it is responsible for producing immune cells. That is, guys, important. So unusual in that it is largest at childhood and progressively, day by day, what happened? It shrinks after puberty. As we age, our thymus shrinks and is replaced by fatty tissue. How it replaced fatty tissue and losing its essential ability to grow and develop T cells, that is a T lymphocyte, and leaving us susceptible to infections and immune disorders and cancer. So guys, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you soon with another new video, and keep watching and keep practicing. Thank you so much.